Good afternoon, lovely people. Welcome back to the farm. And today we're doing a bunch of things today. We're going to be moving the sheep. We're going to be letting the big red broilers get out of their chicken tractors, and we're going to have them free ranging inside a electric poultry net. And we're also grilling. We've got 10 racks of ribs, maybe one or two more for us. We're really smoking. My grill smoker. So this is where the food magic happens. This meat candy you see here is for tomorrow, and we're just making sure it stays nice and moist. Plus, you know, a lot of people, they spray their meat down, but they don't do it for the flavor. They just do it to keep it moist. We're doing it to keep it moist and for the flavor. So we're gonna let that go for about another 10-15 minutes, and then we're going to wrap it in foil for the rest of the time that it has out here. Let's go move some chickens out of their chicken tractors and onto the free range pasture in our backyard. There's 200 feet of poultry net that we've got here to set up. So we're going to do that back here somewhere. We are going to be measuring off the space. I found that a measuring wheel works really good. The time that it saves is incredible, and you can get a really accurate layout for your fence. So I'm gonna go 200 feet, just kind of eyeball it, where we're gonna be turning and everything. Yeah, we'll see where we go from there, I guess. So we'll start it in just a little closer to the tree. So as you can see, if you just went around, started laying your fence out, you'd probably figure out real quick before you started setting it up that it's not going to work. But this just makes it so you can get the exact layout that you want and that the fence is going to fit. So I've had, what, 2-3 times now that I've gone around. Every time, you know, I've come up short or a little long, or it's just not quite going to work. So we're going to try one more here. Onto that stake in the bottom of this. And this one we're gonna put on this green wire. This green wire here is the superconductor. It's got the most metal in it. So we're gonna just put it on there so that we make sure that we come in contact with the green wire. And then we'll turn it on. Well, let's not turn it on yet, I guess. Let's let the chickens out. Something like 150 chickens in here. A little more than that, actually. Almost 160. All right, we'll see what happens. We've lost a couple of the big red broiler, I don't think we lost any of the big red broilers, but we did lose some of the Cornish cross that I bought later on. So these guys are going to love it out here, though. It's gonna be great for them to be able to just roam free and enjoy life out under the trees and in the grass. But they're super active right now. They're just running all over the place, jumping, flapping their wings, challenging each other. You've got three different you've got three different chicken tractors here who've just been introduced to each other, and yes, they are loving life. We'll be right back. way the meat birds were meant to be raised, in my personal opinion. They're gonna really enjoy this, I can tell. It's gonna be a good life for them. They're gonna be healthier, stronger. It's gonna be better quality meat. I wonder how long it'll take before they start trying to roost in that tree there. It's gonna be really good for them to be out here like this. So. And as soon as we get the last of the first batch of big red broilers butchered, then we'll take those fences and we'll just expand this out to the rest of the yard here so that they've got even more space and can do their job fertilizing our yard. The peppers are for me?
Yes. Red peppers.
Oh, those look like some really great peppers.
Oh!
Can we give one to the chickens and see what they do?
Wow.
I'm just kidding.
No. Are you glad that we have chickens?
Yes.
Do you like doing your chicken chores?
No.
Makes you responsible young people.
I'm responsible for taking care of babies.
You're responsible for taking care of babies?
Yeah, not chickens.
You like taking care of babies?
I've always wanted to be a babysitter, and now I'm stuck here.
I think your chicken wants to get down and play.
Bye-bye.
Want me to cut those up? Sure. Are those all of our carrots?
Nope. There's still more in there.
So just a little bit of our carrot harvest. Those are some pretty good ones. Those are some good sized ones for sure, yeah. Ow. All right, let's get out of here and get the fence turned back on.
Wayne,
you get to go turn the fence on. All right, there we go. All in a couple hours of work. Those ribs are smelling mighty good. I gotta get them wrapped in foil. That is some meat candy right there. Folks, you're in for a treat. Everybody at the gathering tomorrow. Mm-mm. Always remember, the shiny side goes toward the food. I don't know how many times I've had to tell people, shiny side goes towards the food. You put the shiny side toward the outside, you know what's gonna happen? It's gonna reflect all that heat away from the meat, and it's gonna take longer to cook. So like I was saying earlier, this is one part apple cider vinegar to one part water. It gives it a really tangy flavor. That's why I like to use it. You can use whatever you want. There was a time when I did one part apple cider vinegar to one part water to one part pineapple juice. And that was really interesting, but it was just a little too sweet for me. The rub that I use is already really sweet. And now people, again, they say they don't use it for flavor. They're not adding flavor to it. What they're doing is they're keeping the meat moist. Okay, well, why not do it both ways? Why not moisture and flavor? Have infused that meat. Steam it, get it nice and moist, and just filled with that oh-so-tangy flavor of apple cider vinegar. I mean, there's recipes, barbecue sauce and stuff, but it just straight up calls for apple cider vinegar, so. All right, then we're just gonna stack these up, let them cook a little bit longer. So I think I'm gonna let them go for about another hour. I can already tell they're just about ready to fall off the bone. So we'll see, I may not even let them go that long. I really should have, put foil on them maybe a couple hours ago. I was waiting for that crust, you know, that nice smoky bark that forms on the outside of the meat. I was waiting for that. The recipe I follow is pretty easy. It's like 1 to 2 hours smoking on low heat, about 225 to 250, 1 hour in foil. So they've actually been going for about 2-3 hours, longer than that maybe. Yeah, like 3 hours.
It is time to move the sheep.